the mic?
Yo. Well, you can't.
Well, yeah. If we don't hear it, but you hear it, then just let us know.
Yo. I got nothing.
Good.
Yo. Yeah, it's cool.
Test. A little lower?
Yo.
What's up?
One, test. One.
No, you're not hooked up. He's the only one hooked up to this speaker.
All right.
Everything else is running through the board.
Yeah, but I can see the levels, and you're good.
Yeah.
Maybe bring me up a little bit?
Okay.
Yo. I mean in the board. Yo. That's cool.
Walk.
So you want to run through hardship first?
Alright.
Then we'll play the set for real.
So this doesn't have to be a lot. This is their joy run.
Just start off with the first song.
I record everything, Susie.
Oh, you got it. That was tight. I like that.
How's that sound?
That was good for me. Wait, that was good for you?
Can't get the answer on Jeopardy.
Alright, so let me know when you're ready.
I'm ready.
It looks like we are ready. Ladies and gentlemen, miscreants of all ages, all those listening at home and abroad, I know we got people in Brazil and Japan, of course, listening to this, and maybe tuning in live to the live stream. We are indeed Iconicide, been around in the underground for 28 godforsaken years. And I want to thank Wade for having us down here in Radio Land. And we're going to have a little bit of inspirational music for you. Some little ditties, some positive vibes flowing through your veins. And going to start off with the religious portion of our programming, a little of what we call worship.
Worship.
now, the title track from our new album. Our real bass player died, but he's still on our new album. His name's Shane Keel. Rest in peace. We got TJ Froll from Universal Truth Machine picking up a four-string cannon. And of course, in the rear corner, man, the heavy artillery, it's Madge the Beast. This one, if you go on CD Baby and other fine venues, you can get this online. You get a CD for $9.99 or a download for $6.66. This one is called Give Me Extinction or Give Me Death! Actually, no. This is not that song. This song goes out to all the working stiffs out there. Everybody got paid yesterday. The money's already gone. Working for the weekend, racking up that overtime, your paycheck is your sentence. Because work is a fucking crime. Workers of the world, fuck off! We'll be right back. by the way, that song is on our live album, Jesus Corpse DNR. We can also get on CD Baby and elsewhere. I think you need to download it on App Store if they're still running. Anyway.
Happy birthday, Pat Marinelli.
Yes, Pat, happy birthday. This is your gift. And by the way, gift is German for poison. So here is your birthday gift. Give me extinction. Or give me death. more type of fucking attitude he has to be. This motherfucker's battling a hell of a fucking war just to keep on this side of the fucking earth.
Woo!
Alright. Okie doke, well, we really don't just want hipsters to die. I mean, that's just like a pocket hobby or something. Everyone needs something to keep them busy. You know, there's only really one race or group of people who really should be wiped off the face of the earth, and that's the human race. Everyone knows that. This one is a public service announcement. Go online and log on to www.vhemt.org. This is a public service announcement for the Voluntary Human Extinction Movement. Yeah, and I started. Thank you. like every politician on the face of the earth in the course of history, I lied. That was not, well, that was our national anthem. But this next song is the first Iconicide song ever rehearsed. And is the national anthem for every planet on the face of the fucking, every country on the face of the fucking planet. It's a little number called Doomed Patriots. they're going to feel that that's an anti-American song. That song is not anti-American. That's anti-anyone who thinks that pathetic rag means more than they do. If you don't respect yourself, to quote Ruth Paul, if you don't love yourself, how the fuck are you going to love anybody else? Can I get an amen?
Amen.
Yay. Jiggly Caliente didn't win either.
Okay.
Yay.
Okay, well, this one is one of Live Tracks, our new album, by the way. Give Me Extinction or Give Me Death, available on CD Baby and other venues. It's half studio, half live. We recorded the studio side in one day, live and direct to the board at this place in Brooklyn called Vinegar Hill Studios. And this is one of the live tracks off that album. Going out to my The Rapist. You can figure that out. It's a little number called Higher Self.
On the WADIO.
Thank you.
Yourselves.
Now it's way too loud. TJ, I don't need a point that on me anymore. Now it's collapsed in my ears.
Now TJ is way too close. Alright, once again, I want to thank everyone out there on WADIO Land for tuning in to WADIO. What wonderful, wonderful WADIO. WADIO. Wade Banks. Now, a lot of people are not really hip to this whole internet radio promotion thing, and they're not willing to just, take advantage of it. I mean, damn, this guy's doing this out of his own fucking home, all right? Woo! It's not like this highfalutin pay-to-play situation. Send him your shit, it'll get played. Easy peasy lemon squeezy. I mean, who can ask for anything more, you know?
Prostitutes!
And if you hear only crap over his station, you have only yourself to blame, because only shitheads are sending stuff in. You want better music? Send better music. All right? Pure and fucking simple.
Radio.
Truer
radio.
Words cannot be spoken. Radio, 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 radio. And once again, we are indeed, for those who are tuning in a little bit early, a little bit late, who don't quite get what's going on here, we are indeed Iconicide. We've been around for 28 godforsaken years. And if you're asking yourself, well, if they've been around for that long, why haven't I heard them? Think about the way the scene is run. Think about the cool kids. Think about all these cliques and shit. Oh, he's my friend, that's my friend's band, this is blah blah blah. See, the same band's playing over and over and over again. You gotta fucking shake things up a bit. Come the fuck on.
Yeah!
Yeah. Yeah, I mean, I didn't know punk rock was about having friends and acting cool. I thought it had to be about being a total fucking miscreant.
Huh?
You know, I mean, please. You know, tell the truth and damn the fucking consequences. Not, oh, you brought the wrong feathers the wrong fucking way. Come the fuck on, give me a break.
Tell people on the computer about this. I gotta check your lyrics nonsense.
Oh, yeah. We got a few shows coming up. We're playing, we're playing in Connecticut in a couple of months, in June. Noel from the Lost Riots is bringing us out there. We're gonna play at this venue, one of the few venues around that still gives 100% of the door to the fucking bands. That's an endangered species right there. And also I got the 16th edition of a female fronted showcase series I've been doing since 2009 called The Witch's Night Out. Also this year will be part 7 of a show series I've been doing at Tompkins Square Park in June called Puke Island. The reason it's called Puke Island is, I'm sure everybody out there is familiar with Punk Island. An ex-squatter by the name of Slug started it in like 2008 or 2009. Total fucking chaos. Over 100 bands. You know, 13 stages scattered around going to this island. And after the third year, it got too big for him to handle. And he figured, oh well, I'll give it to ABC No Real. I'll give it to that to run. And, well, you know. Now, if you want to play Punk Island, you got to submit your lyrics and get it combed over ideologically so they can make sure you're part of the same cult and don't say anything, you know, politically damnable. You know, I mean, a song like Dude the Patriots, you know, oh, he talks about killing Jews, but also about talking killing Palestinians. There's a lyric in Horseshit that says 6 million lies, a necessary loss. We can't have that. We can't fucking have that. You're banned. Free expression, anyone? So I started a show series called Puke Island in Tompkins Square Park. And we got, anyway, you can go on to fucking iconicide.com or check us on fucking, you know, Facebook or YouTube or any other venues that we're available. And also be sure to pick up our two most recent albums on CD Baby. Jesus Corpse DNR is the live album. That was 2010 that came out. And then a year ago, we released Give Me Extinction or Give Me Death. And he's holding it up to the camera right now. Thank you, very nice. And don't just look at the cover graphic. Check out the Voluntary Human Extinction Movement. They got a lot of free to learn about. And that's a live album held at the time of the day. All right, so.
I want to hear the drummer now.
Watch this here. What does the drummer have to say?
Yes. Our views are not necessarily Chris's views because they're very extreme and I'm trying to make a living at this. So what he does is his own business.
Yeah, one of the songs we're going to play later on the set is called OTK, Ode to Ken.
I moved out of my mom's place in 92, moved out of Flatbush. There was a friend, my sister's best friend's ex, and let him move in with me. He totally turned everything to shit. I had to kick him out. They had street gangs tailing me and giving me death threats and shit. Anyway, you know, and one of the female members of the band, she was like, I don't know if I feel safe playing live with Chris on stage because people are going to attack us. No, they're going to attack me, all right? I'm the asshole telling the truth and not ducking, you know? I mean, when we played fucking, the LNG in Connecticut, and we released, a couple of our songs were released on the New York Connecticut Hardcore Connection compilation put out by Dennis from the band Fed Up. He's got a label called United Riot Records. And we played, me and Mario was a two-piece, and two and a half songs into our set, one of the bouncers grabbed me by the neck and hauled me bodily off stage, because he thought we were a fucking Nazi band. What the fuck? Come on, wake the fuck up. Anyway, because he saw one of our t-shirts. So one of our t-shirts is based on our song Scared Sacred. And it has like a skeletal priest with a slave with like a collar around his neck. It says like Christ insanity and all that crap, and his Bible quotes in the background. Anyway, we also have, I gave Wade our EP, Father Son Holocaust. And the cover illustration for Father Son Holocaust has, it shows Jesus on a swastika. And it's not because we like Hitler, we just hate Christ.
But the drummer would like to tell, I love the drummers. This five-piece idea that's been around for a long time since the big band days, where they didn't know what to give drummers. This 12-inch, 13 and 16-inch is bad enough. I like a big tom and then two floor toms or whatever. But now there's this like this poison out there with a 10-inch tom, a 12-inch tom, and a 16, or what I call bing bang bong. You can't make a drum set going bing bang bong. So every time you see that set, boycott that motherfucker so that they stop making it. Period.
Manage the beast. De facto drum tech of every single place we play, even if it's somebody's living room, den, basement, garage, or at the local bus stop or Safeway.
Safeway!
Safeway! There is no Safeway!
Okay. All right. Back to the metal portion. No, it's just dead bodies, right?
Yeah, dead body there.
Speaking of the big band days, Gene Krupa, I gotta tell you, Gene Krupa was a punk rocker. Any drummer who could take the lead like that, set up in front of the fucking band, that's a fucking punk rocker right there. This one was written by accident. I was walking down Avenue A, and I was swallowed in a sea of hipsters. Yay, you know, they're like, anyway. Anyway. This one's called Just Dead Bodies, The Ballad of Fifth and C.
Yeah.
You wonder how your old folks did it?
Buddy Rich.
Damn straight. You know, I had a conversation with Eric Blitz from Missing Foundation, False Prophets, those bands, and the way it used to be, kids were into the heavy stuff, and old fucks were into everything weak. Now us old farts are into the heavy stuff, and his kids were into the fucking weak shit. Think of that out. I guess the drugs have changed.
Just 1 second. You gonna introduce the band?
Yeah, I'm gonna introduce the band. We got over here on the four string, TJ Froles from Universal Truth Machine. And we have, if you remember bands like Omen 2 or Sinner Steel or Armageddon or bands like that. We got Madge the Beast in the rear corner. And yeah, if you don't know who I am, you just haven't read the file yet. Boo-hoo. But you can log on to Iconicide.com. It's I-C-O-N-I-C-I-D-E. Suckers. Also, be sure to pick up the albums if you can, and any compilations we have in the beyond. We're on the New York Connecticut Hardcore Connection compilation on United Riot Records. We're on, there's a Pissed Off Radio compilation, Volume 4, has one of our songs from the album on it. That's in, that's like a cancer rehab. It does benefits for, like, one thing that does cover-up tattoos for people who've had, like, mastectomies and shit. And also another thing that has to do with cancer, and our drummer Magic Beast has some special interest in things cancer related, because that's what he's fucking battling right the fuck now. Take heed. And welcome to WADIO! Yay!
You did mean mastectomies, right?
Lumpectomies, brainectomies.
Oh, I thought you said like...
No.
Mastectomies.
No, mastectomy, vasectomy, but you know what, if you say stethoscope over and over and over, faster and faster it becomes the word testicle. Try it. Say stethoscope, 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 testicle!
There you go.
There you go, stethoscope becomes testicle. That is the word of the day. Yay.
Okay.
Shout out to Wendy's friend. That the first line of their surfer is, life is short and hard, and she saw the lyric sheet, and she says, she's walking around saying, my dick is small and hard, so she don't have one, so they, a lot of them think the clit is big, so like it's doing something, so I said, as long as it's hard, it must be doing something right.
Lesbians call that a dicklet. It's true. By the way, another little lesbian word for you, 12 play. We use the word foreplay. Three holes, no waiting, 12 play. That's what happens when you go to shows in the late 80s. And a wall, at CB's, hardcore matinees, I was the guy with hair. And I'll be off to the right, stage left, and there will be a sea of fucking dykes surrounding me. So like skinheads could never knock me off my feet. It was fucking great. Anyway, you get to learn things. So be kind to your local dyke, okay? Please do. She might be able to help you out in a bar fight.
Yeah!
Yay! Speaking of bitch. Another one to placate any metal. I know a lot of our shit is metal tinged, but there are a few songs that are just straight up fucking metal. Our next album will be a metal album. We've done a lot of shit, and people keep accusing us of being metal, so we figured put out a fucking metal album. This is one of the tracks off that. It's called Usurper. And if you're wondering, yes, like the band Usurper. Rick Scythe sort of split off and made his own band Scythe, named after himself, because people do that. Like that other metal band, Madonna.
What?
Oh yeah. When Lady Gaga was on that award show, and she sang with Metallica, they did not introduce Metallica. Metallica was on stage and Lady Gaga was singing with them. They only introduced Lady Gaga, and they did not give James Hetfield whatever. They did not give him a working microphone.
No, they did not.
They didn't. And two times for 30 seconds, she felt pity on the old man. And she held her microphone in front of him, but then she walked away. Aww. So if anyone is pissed off at that...
Was that a psych?
Psych. Yeah, I miss when people fucking said that. Psych. Yo, man, I'll help you out. Psych. I'll help you out. There's the door.
Who started that? Lucy and Charlie with the football psych?
Lucy? You got a lot of explaining to do. Okay, I explain.
How come Charlie Brown kept trusting Lucy? That's like a male-female classic relationship right there, right? She's like, no, I won't take it away this time, but she always did.
Was it Bob Barry, one of my good friends out there, Bob Barry, there was this new movie called Eye of the Needle, I think it was called. Anyway, no, White of the Eye, I believe it was called. And there's this one thing where like there's a wall or something, like a pane of glass, and this guy throws something at it, and the glass shatters in this huge gaping hole, and it's sucking things out. He's like, if that's not female, I don't know what the fuck is! If anyone tells you that they're the center of your universe, remember, the center of the universe is a black hole, and it sucks.
What do you think about that radio?
Yeah.
Them's the yolks, folks.
Let's rock.
Let's rock.
The storytelling of abortion has to be in the mix somewhere.
Hell yeah.
This one is called Usurper. And you do check out the band Usurper, by the way, because I bought it because I had the T-shirt. And I know I borrowed this home before the T-shirt, but anyway, whatever. Usurper. I trust you as far as I can comfortably spit a rat.
Forget about it. Don't worry about nothing. Don't worry about nothing.
Okay, take a seat. We'll be right back. did not say before that song that this is the part of the set where Mick Jagger goes off stage to do coke and lets Keith sit Richard in a couple of songs. But yeah, this is the second song that Matt sings lead on. This song is on Give Me Extinction or Give Me Death. And we're back to the reggae portion of our program. Of course, it's cheap, piece of shit, second or third or fifth generation dancehall reggae, of course. And this song was written, once again, by accident. It's dedicated to our fallen bass player, Shane Keogh, because he saw me fucking around on the guitar. And I'm not playing anything, I'm making noise. He's like, what's that? I'm like, oh, I'm done, I don't know. I want to learn it. Teach this to me. So I taught him, and I had to write words, and I had to come up with a song. And it's all your fault, Shane. Crime and Punishment.
Shane had a really good sense of humor. He always made me laugh. And the member that did the album, that he's not here for Greener Pastures, he's one of those guys like that. He's on mescaline or some shit, like he's always a talker. Like in a Seinfeld episode, you're a fast talker, right? And he would say, it's like you put a fucking beehive on my head, like all the bees came out, like busy bees. I can't stand them. I'm like, exactly. I'm like you, easygoing, like a street level kid. I can't stand that either. So like, I bothered him right away because I can't stand that motherfucker running his mouth either. I would die laughing because it was so true. I hate the people like that. What are you doing? Like, it's too much. It's too much.
You know? Yeah, you need a fucking fly swatter. Just bat him out of the air.
Wasn't Shane Keogh a cop killer? A guy named Shane Keogh, there was two brothers that they were wanted for killing cops.
No, this Shane Keogh was the bass player for a band called Lucifer Jones. Oh. You know Eric Bond? Yeah. That's Shane Keogh.
Joe Demolition joined them.
Lucifer. Yeah, he did. He did for a while. Yeah. Actually, they got a new album in the works. Eric has been sort of soured from the whole persona that people like had him in. That like, ooh, like a cartoon character, like a vampire or whatnot. It's like, man, fuck that shit. You know, now he's like, he's got his own like film production company and he's coming back with that stuff. But he is making music and it is not pretty. And you can't wait to hear it. I can see you smiling.
Hey, I hope you send it to me.
Right. Shane, this next song is all your fault. Crime and Punishment. We'll be right back.
listening.
Yay! Wonderful, wonderful WADIO. Wonderful WADIO.
That comic earthquake, though, like, he says, when he find a girl they want to make her pregnant, he says, I leave it up to the girl, I trust you, like what you said. I trust you, you won't get pregnant. Wishful thinking, huh?
Alright, anybody out there read a comic called Slackjaw, the sky by the name of Jim Kerfol? He's got retinitis pigmentosis, he's a total fucking misanthrope, wonderful human being. He's got a bunch of books out, including Quitting the Nairobi Trio, These Children Who Come at You with Knives, a lot of stuff. Look it up. The Buzzing, Noogie's Time to Shine, bunch of shit. Real good guy. Anyway, I wrote this song for him back in like 92 or 94, somewhere around there. He's looking Jim Kniffel, K-N-I-P-F-E-L. Anyway, I wrote this song for him. And everyone, sci-fi geeks out there, even, you know, the Hitchhiker's Guide to the Galaxy. Great answer. The answer to the great question of life, the universe, and everything is 42. Uh-uh. The number is a little bit more than twice that. And that number is 99. As in 99%
crap.
I heard Wade play that a couple days ago. Yeah. So you can join in on backing vocals. Remember, if you look deep inside, you just might find something real.
That's all about the backing vocals.
But I got it.
It's all about the backing vocals with the crap. 99%.
Oh, yeah. Our guitar player, Jeremy, who's down in Mexico teaching English, he couldn't quite get the pacing, because a lot of this shit is based on Scandinavian hardcore and shit like that, mixed in with all the other, like, influences. I hate that fucking word! That word should never be in the punk dictionary! Influences! I'll influence you with a brick! Anyway, a lot of it is on top or even slightly ahead of the beat. And in order to, we did gang vocal, we did everything in one day, recorded 9 songs in 10 hours. Bill and a post and also started doing mixing and mastering. And we got gang vocal, including the Reverend Rondo, who's
Hello.
Including Guzzy from Armed Citizens, who spent most of the day passed out. I love the guy, I really do. But, I mean, the first thing you do is you grab two little suitcases of beers and just start chugging. Man, I love you guys! Anyway.
He made it a point to tell the guy he didn't like the house drum set, which is more expensive than anything he could ever afford, like CS. So he's like, I don't give a fuck if I do anything.
Well, I mean, his sister did make him throw out his own drum set, so take pity on the guy. But anyway. We were doing backup vocal, everyone, including Lee Lawless and TJ from Universal Truth Machine. And Fastlane, not that hip-hop guy Fastlane, the real Fastlane for bands like Porno Dracula. Anyway, and everyone's like, yo, if you listen to this, night eyes for the crap! And Jeremy couldn't quite get it up to speed. And he was like, 99% crap! 99% crap! Like, no. Drop the fucking vowel. You're not on Wheel of Fortune. You don't need the fucking vowel. Drop it. Put a little fucking, like, fucking, like, little fucking fuck. A fucking fucker, fucker. And a little apostrophe, that's the word. Put a little apostrophe between P and C. Percent. You come from New York, right? Percent. You say percent, right? You don't say percent. What are you doing dragging your word out like that? 99% crap. No, 99% crap.
That's the 1%
that sucked also. Anyway, yeah. Jeremy's making a good life for himself down in New Mexico way. 99%.
And TJ is on the record, but as the bass player.
Since Shane died, I picked up guitar, but you see how I play, right? I beat my instruments half to death. So we needed someone who actually knew how to play guitar, because it's more noticeable. And if people treat the bass like it's a percussive instrument, that's actually respected in the world today. Okay, one more.
And there's the cover song, cover as far as the lyrics go. So that's the blues. And TJ really made that one. He really shines on that, because he knows that blues shit, you know?
Damn straight.
Damn straight.
Because he died like that.
Yeah, well, well, Mario said earlier, you know, we're not all in agreement, but I just wanted to point out, you know, Chris made the public service announcement about the voluntary human extinction movements. You know,
TJ believes it should not be voluntary.
Some of us think it should not be voluntary.
Some should be.
That should be mandatory.
Mandatory. Thank you.
So I just want to point out, we don't all agree with the voluntary human extinction.
Well, thing is, it is an actual movement. This guy by the name of, his pseudonym is Les Unite. And their slogan is, let us live long and die out. I'm not that patient. Time for violent retribution, human extinction, the only solution. Not 6 million dead, billion with a B. Billion, 6 billion dead, billion.
Well, just
dead.
Think of the chunk you'd take out of society if we just got rid of the hipsters. That would be a good chunk
anyway,
of New York.
That's, you know, hipsters, the other white meat. There are black hipsters, though. It's sad, but it's true. You see them around. I saw this guy in the subway, and he was wearing a baseball cap and said, I want to be dead, too. Okay.
It has nothing to do with the music, but as far as the storytelling and getting people involved, I love Saturday Night Fever movie. I think the dancing is incidental. It's the words, the dialogue that makes it. And there's a one part where the guy's trying to convince the priest that he made the girl pregnant. Like, how can he get out of it God-wise? Like, how can he get absolved from getting her pregnant? And he says, my girlfriend loves the taste of communion wafers. Now, that's like a perfect line unto itself. But does anybody know, like, in what context was that meant to be in the movie? Like, was he impressing the priest by saying that? Because that's like a kind of creepy thing to say, because the wafer don't have any taste. So what does it mean if she likes the taste of communion wafers when it's like a dead bread tasting thing, right? Does anybody have a clue about that?
No, that's kind of like saying that the Pope's dick tastes scrumptious.
That's
all
the Catholic kids out there will be like, yep.
Yep.
I think they deserve a shout out too.
Yo. Okie doke, on that note, let's get back to some music. 99% crap. Crap. Okie doke, we only got a couple more left. Imagine that. Thank you, Wade, for letting us take our time. I mean, when I asked this guy, like, so how long do we get? I mean, we got to drive all, we got, someone's got to take the railroad, the subway, and the railroad to get out of here. What? How much time do we have once we get there? No time limit. Okay, so, okay, cool. We'll play a 19-song set.
Damn straight.
Yeah! Been around 28 years, so 19 songs for 28 years. That's like 88, that's like oh, yeah. 88 for 77 for 81. If you went for, I gotta tell that story. I got kicked out of public school midway through second grade, but in first grade, they took all the kids out to the schoolyard, and the entire school did the hustle. Yeah. And the vice principal, he was like an ex-clown or something.
Okay, yeah, he ran the clown college.
And the thing is, he had this thing where he wanted to break world records. So he's gonna have the entire school go out to the schoolyard and do the hustle. He had boom boxes and everything. And me, 7 years old, a morbid fucking kid, thought he's emptying out the entire school to the schoolyard so he could shoot us. And when he didn't, I was fucking pissed! I was so disappointed that he didn't kill us! But anyway, he also passed out t-shirts to the entire school, white t-shirts. They had barrels of purple dye. And this was before I knew about the Guyana massacre with Jim Jones. And it's Flavor-Aid, not Kool-Aid. It was strawberry fucking Flavor-Aid! He did not buy the name brand! So, he drank the Kool-Aid. Fuck you! Fuck you, motherfucker! It was Flavor-Aid! Learn your fucking history! Anyway, these barrels of yellow, of purple dye. And the idea was that he gave us each a white t-shirt and a bunch of rubber bands. And we were supposed to put the rubber bands on the shirts and make number eights and dump them in the purple dye so you'd have bootleg tie-dye t-shirts for eights on them. Mind you, the name of the school, it was PS81 on the borderline of Brooklyn and Queens on the Bushwick-Ridgewood border. And the idea, it was 1977. And they were saying, well, if it's 1977, why are we tie-dyeing white number eights on these purple t-shirts? What do number eights have to do with being with the year? Have to do with it being the year 1977. And the explanation was, from the motherfucker's mouth himself, that, and this is gonna blow your mind when you hear it, because it makes absolutely no fucking sense whatsoever, but I remembered it like I remember everything in my fucking life. It was 88 for 77 for 81. 88 for 77 for 81. 90, it was 88 because it was 1977. It was PS81. 88 for 77 for 80. Oh, now he gets it. Now he fucking sees it. It makes no fucking sense whatsoever. And you repeated it. You repeated it so people go, oh, that's why we're tie-dying white number eights on a purple shirt. And doing those. I'm like, oh, God. Can they shoot us after the hustle? The hustle.
I don't want to fuck up you guys' name, but Chuck Berry died.
Oh, really?
So did Rowan Atkinson.
So, what?
Lord Edmund Blackadder, a.k.a. Mr. Bean, he also died this morning.
That's what they said. That's what they've been saying.
That's what they've been saying. I do not mourn Mr. Bean. I never watched that show. But Lord Edmund Blackadder was a fucking bastard, and he was really good at it. Yeah, and of course, you know, if they actually did try to tie-dye a seven, it would not work.
Mr. Bean didn't die.
Oh, good!
Oh, shit.
So that's why we're giving out free pills.
However, the voice of Zorak died. Zorak is dead, and I am sad. Tears. Zorak is dead, and I am sad. All right, I was talking about that guy who I kicked out of the play out of my apartment in Flatbush. The song that I wrote for him. I wrote this song in '93 or '92 or '93, and we still play it to this day. So it was a total piece of shit, you know, waste of human space. But we got a pretty good song out of him. It's called OTK, Ode to Ken.
Yeah.
Whee! I want this guy to come to one of our shows. So I said, this song goes out to you. But he's never showed up! He's gotta be out there. I ran into a couple of times. But he didn't fucking recognize me. I mean, how is it that you I got like an hour's worth of death threats on the phone from this motherfucker, and he doesn't recognize me! Wah.
You know what you're on WADIO.
Well, if you can, if you're out there, this is a private joke between me and Ken. E-cat sub! E-cat sub! Because the L train wasn't running and they had the take bus sign, but they put it upside down so it said E-cat sub. E-cat sub! E-cat sub! OTK, Ode to Ken. And,
thank you.
shearing it off the pot. You have no fucking idea how many people cripple themselves staying in shit that should never have existed in the first place.
Okay.
I know Chisholm from the band Ism, a close personal ally of ours, is probably listening to us out there in Radio Land, in WADIO Land.
WADIO Land.
And this song, this next song is one that he says, he claims that he wants to cover sometime in the near future. And I give him, you know, fucking respect. That guy's a fucking lifer. This goes out to you, Chisholm. Higher Forms of Murder. He can't remember.
Can't remember.
Okay, now he remembers.
Yeah. Right, ready?
They usually remember it after they start playing it. My childhood is that bad. It's called Just a Child.
Somebody put a R.I.P. Buck Cherry.
Buck Cherry?
Yeah. Instead of Chuck Berry.
Oh.
Buck Cherry, Chuck Berry. Shit, oh, fuck.
I like how he says you don't carry an amp or a guitar, he doesn't have a suitcase, a toothbrush, and a change of shirt, and he gets everything where he's going. I thought that was awesome. Fucking awesome. It's always the bands that are professional. professional, which is a good thing on the radio to mention. Mm-hmm. It's always professional bands that don't give a fuck about equipment. It's always a wannabe band, so I gotta have everything like just right. Yeah. It takes me a half hour to set up, you know? And professional people, they don't give a fuck.
Yeah, all I gotta do is, can you plug it in? Does it make noise? Is it loud? Can you hear me, motherfucker? That's all I care about.
Yeah, I mean, shit.
But this is a nice fucking setup. Anyone down there, anyone out there who's interested in playing, who's fucking worth their weight in anything, contact this guy, you know. Hey, beauty up the airwaves a bit. There's a lot of crap out here, and, well, you know. Back to the topic at hand. Justice Rock. Amazing fucking comp. It's like 26 or 27 songs, and we got two. The two songs that are on that comp are from an album that was never released called Godspeed, which died in somebody's basement next to the family dog. But anyway, United Riot Records, New York, Connecticut Hardcore Connection, look it up, and be sure, once again, to pick up both of our most recent albums, Jesus Corpse DNR, the live album, and also Give Me Extinction or Give Me Death, both of which are on CD, baby. But
I just say shout out to Johnny D visiting the NYC.
Yo, Johnny Donuts.
Kathy Chaos and my man Big Vin from Sci-Fi Ninja Theater.
Yeah.
Yo, Vinny Meatball.
And I always say it's four words. How can people say Sci-Fi Theater Ninja?
Hello, Ninja Theater Sci-Fi. Oh yeah, motherfucker. That motherfucker goes places. He goes everywhere.
Yes.
Everywhere. He goes up to people who you would never approach. He's like, can I get a hug? It's for the fans. No, it's really for me. The guy's amazing. He sees the world at breast level. Right?
Very impressive.
Right? And he's totally non-threatening. He's like low-key. You know, he just like walks right up to him like, hey, can I ask you a couple of questions? And they're like, sure. You know? And any action that he gets, you know, God bless his twisted heart. But yeah, also a shout out to a number of my if I were to start doing a shout out list, you know, we'll be up here for like a couple of days straight. There's so many fucking people. Chris Flash, Dave Huberman, Eek the Geek, JD Rage, fucking damn. I'm gonna leave everybody out. Just you know what you do? Buy the live album if you can find a hard copy. Instead of lyrics or anything, the entire inside of the 12-panel foldout is a thanks column. There's 1,000 fucking people on that thank. I thanked everyone. I thanked the girl in high school who I creeped out, who a friend of hers years later saw me cross the street and stared knives at me. I thanked her. But since we're all happy and happy staying with love, this is the last song of the day. Wah, wah, wah. And it's the happiest, most positive, heartwarming song on the face of a fucking planet. Or at least it should be. Since the weather is finally starting to warm up a little bit, yay, heat wave, woo, it's in the 40s now, yay! It's time for one thing, and one thing only. It's time for a world's end. World end! No! Sharper. You want me to start it? online, there's a scene called Autoerotic Asphyxium Scene. And say what you want about it, positive or negative, but we spent a couple of months going back and forth with the guy who does that scene to finally interview the band in depth for the first time in a good many years. And if you've ever wondered what's going on in this sick little twisted head of mine, or what anything, what does it mean? What does it mean? Read that interview. And as Magic Beast would say, any other questions, just refer back to that. It says a lot of shit that we've been wanting to say for quite some time about the music, about the scene, about society in general, and about all you little people on the bottom. Thank you once again for Wade for having us out here.
No doubt.
And keep tuning in to WADIO because it's 100% local music, all done from the motherfucking heart. One thing that Wade did tell me in one of the emails, it took a few grand to outfit in this fucking place. Yeah. And is he asking for any sort of tribute? No. All he wants is for you people to send what you want to fucking hear. You got a band, you want it played, you send it fucking in. Alright? And if only crap is out there, if only crap is being played over his station, it's because you only sent in crap! Make better music, people! I'm not gonna actually drop this mic because it's my mic.
I can't dispute WADIO radio because it's indisputable.
You can't dispute it because it's indisputable.
Indisputable.
Yes.
WADIO.
Wonderful WADIO. And of course, log on to Iconicide.com. That's Iconicide. We also, of course, endorse the Volunteer Human Extinction Movement. That's VHEMT.org. Also, I don't want to forget to mention the Church of Euthanasia. Their one commandment, thou shalt not procreate. There are four sacraments, sodomy, abortion, cannibalism, and suicide. So you can hold those four up, then you got four things that you're holding up. Yay. And of course, the two albums, get them. CD Baby, also your connected hardcore condition. Also, that cancer treatment benefit compilation, which is it's like 80 some odd bands.
Nice.
And it's only $10, I think. It's only $10 to download off of, look for Pissed Off Radio, and, he's got it, and we got one song from the new album, Go to Hell, because if you want to know what a band sounds like, they just plug directly into the soundboard, don't have any sort of tracking, no preparation, we just plugged in and played live, and we recorded an album. If you want to know the quality of that album, well, Wade's been playing a couple of songs off it already, and, the song Go to Hell is on the cancer patients benefit album. And also read the words. They're really fucking important. You might learn. And as Bill Cosby, that bastard, is famous for saying, you better be careful or you might learn something before it's done.
Yeah. Damn it.
Damn it. Merry Christmas, damn it!
Iconicide in the motherfucking WADIO house.
WADIO!
Whoop whoop!
Yeah. All right. Signing off.